it's this kind of zombie horror genre with characters that you can relate to that are, you know, very much human. Not characters that, you know, kind of built to be these, like, you know, superheroes or anything like that. It's people in real scenarios, and it's more about the relationships than, you know, I guess the genre of the show. Yeah, I think everybody kind of balances each other out. You know, there are some characters that are incredibly strong physically, and there are other characters that are incredibly strong emotionally. You know, I think more specifically, Noah brought, you know, a sense of innocence to the group that was kind of, you know, missing in a way. Just to kind of remind them that, yeah, it's, you don't have to be that hard, and there are people who are still, you know, adjusting to this world. But yeah, I think that's what this group is about. It's all about checks and balances. That, you know, you have those who are just, you know, you really go for it, take you know, walk her down type people, and then you have those who are just going to emotionally sit there and think about it, and that's what this group does well. It was interesting, you know, we really kind of took it as seriously as we possibly could. You know, Stephen and I were adamant about not, you know, breaking it up at all, that, you know, no matter what angle we were doing it on, doing the entire scene in one take each time. So it was, you know, difficult. We shot it all day long, and, you know, it was incredibly emotional. And by the time we were all said and done, it was exhausting at the end of the day. But, it, you know, it translated on screen, which is what we really want. Yeah, I think just to be different, you know, because I would say the same thing, but I'd probably have to say Slab Town. That whole escape kind of montage that we were kind of going through. It was really interesting, you know. I think Mike Satrodemus did a great job shooting it and making it look real and feeling that energy that was in there. So yeah, I think that'd be it. But, you know, like Christian said, it's every day for us is that. There are scenes that are, you know, we had the whole, another one is the whole bit in the barn. We're all at the barn door, which is just like, you know, as a unit and as a group of people who, like, you know, act together, for us to all be there in the physical manifestation of what we feel like is happening to us daily, was a beautiful thing. And yeah, it was just a great day.
Yeah.
Human beings are obsessed with their own demise for some reason, just how it's all going to end. So anything really apocalyptic has been, like, you know, kind of going crazy right now, especially since we're, you know, at this place where we have so many different levels of technology and we're functioning so well as human beings, that I think now we begin to think, you know, how long is this ride going to happen? You know, when is eventually all going to end? So I think, you know, the whole zombie aspect of it is just another form of the apocalypse that, you know, everyone's looking for. You know, in 2012, it was the Mayans and however that was supposed to go down. And this right now is like, you know, that whole zombie aspect. So I think that's mainly what it is that people are just waiting for the world to end. And, you know, this shows what it might be like when it happens.
Favorite Walker takedown.
Yeah, I have to say in the last one, there was one that a lot of people kind of missed. After the explosion, there was a shrapnel stuck in one of the walker's heads. And I just thought it was cool that Noah came down with his gun on the piece of shrapnel rather than hitting it in the head. And it kind of split the head in two. That was kind of cool. Absolutely. There's so much love and respect. And continue to watch and enjoy. And these guys will take care of it. I know they will.
Aww. Come back.